The moment we heard about the slide, ADOT started pulling together a wide group of both professionals and affected folks in the constituencies to look at how we are going to provide safety and mobility to the public.
We looked at the immediate, intermediate, and ultimate solutions. The immediate solution actually took place within the first 3 weeks. We did start the geotechnical investigation, and we were able to establish immediate access for emergency responders. The interim repair, the paving of N20, is under the design phase right now, and hopefully we'll be paving shortly. And then the ultimate repair of US 89 will eventually get a recommendation from our geotechnical engineers on a solution. Making sure that we restore essential traffic in the area is very important to the department, to the Navajo DOT, to FHWA, to the community in general. The existing N20 is approximately 45 miles long, 27 miles of it is dirt. Some areas are difficult to drive because of the soft sand. The washboard condition is very rough on the school buses and on the cars, and the increased traffic is not helping that condition. So we are hoping by expediting this project that we can get out and get that road paved, reestablishing that essential traffic in and around that area and trying to alleviate that burden that the existing detour has caused with the additional 45 plus miles that people have to drive taking US 160 to 98.
I think what this incident has brought home when the mountain slid is that we can't take the transportation system for granted. People rely on it a great deal to get from point A to point B, but also for many, many other things, whether that's transporting school children or for emergency services or for the tourism industry. Transportation is one of those networks that we find once we don't have it, it's very difficult to live without it. What I would ask from the taxpayers is to be patient. The mountain has moved, and literally to fix that roadway, we are going to have to move that mountain in some way, or we're going to have to figure out a way to go around it. These are not quick and easy decisions to make because they do involve a great deal of technical issues in the engineering and geology areas, but we are working on this as diligently as we can.
ADOT, keeping Arizona moving.